that the reason that we don't even explore the possibility of what to do is because subconsciously we don't believe that it can happen for us, and we don't believe that we deserve it. How much time do you spend working on you? How much time do you spend every day working on your dream? In the last 90 days, how many books have you read? In the last year, what new skill or knowledge have you acquired? What kind of investment have you made in you? Take the plunge. Go into action. And ladies and gentlemen, you will be surprised at how things will come together. Ladies and gentlemen, go into action with your dream. And don't avoid where the fights are. Get in the midst of the fight. And get some hickeys on your head. Get knocked down so you can learn how to fight, so you can hold your position. See, most people don't get out in the arena of life because they don't want to fight. Most people don't get out there because they don't want to get knocked down. They don't want to be dropped to their knees. But see, you're going to be dropped whether you're on the field or whether or not you're sitting on the sidelines. You're going to be dropped. So at least get dropped for something. Don't get knocked down while you're sitting down. See, that's how most people are spectators in life. You don't want to be a spectator. You want to get out in the field where the action is, and you will be amazed. After the struggle, there will be a calm period, and things will begin to click for you.
What would your life be like? And I'm saying to you that all of us who have been entombed by fear have the capacity to resurrect ourselves. Is it easy? No. It's not easy. Can I do it? Yes. What's one of the ways to get started? Some of us need somebody to hold our hands. Sometimes we need somebody to help us out. Be willing to say, I don't know. Be willing to reach out. Be willing to get some assistance to take you to the next level. What great athlete. You never expect boxers to make profound statements. I think it was Joe Frazier who said this one. He says, all of us are like the blind man at some point in our lives standing on the corner waiting for somebody to lead us across. See, all of us at some point in our lives need some help, need someone to reach out to us, to throw out the lifeline, to help us go across some treacherous waters that we couldn't navigate by ourselves. None of us do it by ourselves. All of us at some point of our lives, we need that kind of help. We need that kind of assistance. Because we grow from the people we have in our lives that can enrich our lives personally, professionally, spiritually, and all the dimensions of our lives. We don't grow in a vacuum. So as you look at yourself, what are the fears you have that maybe you need some help in strengthening yourself in that area? As you assess your strengths and your weaknesses, as you begin to prove yourself and your passions and your dreams and your goals and the things that you want, if you decide to experience all of your true potential, as you decide to manifest all of your greatness, as you decide, wait a minute, what else is available to me out here? If I decided to experience the fear of rejection, the fear of no, the fear of failure, the fear of standing by myself, what else is available? Of taking a chance, a fear of losing it all. What else is available to me that will bring some extra meaning and value?
Receiving is not the problem. You don't have to work on receiving. It's automatic. So if receiving is not the problem, what is the problem? It's failing to ask. The man says, I see it now. I got up every day this year and hit it hard, but nowhere in my house is there a list of what I want from my life. Can you see? Good worker, poor asker. Third, receiving is like the ocean. There's plenty, especially in this country. It's like an ocean here. Here, success is not in short supply. It isn't rationed so that when you step up to the window, it's all gone. No, no. Well, if that's true, what is the problem? Well, the problem is some people go to the ocean with a teaspoon. Have you got the picture? A teaspoon. What I suggest you do in view of the size of the ocean is trade your teaspoon for at least a bucket. And you will look better at the ocean with a bucket. Kids won't make fun of you. Now, here's something else to remember about asking. There are two ways to ask. One is ask with intelligence. It didn't say ask intelligently, but I'm sure it meant that. Don't mumble. You won't get anything by mumbling. Be clear, be specific. Intelligent asking means how high, how long, how much, when, what size, what model, what color. Describe what you want. Define it. Remember, well-defined goals are like magnets. The better you define them, the stronger they pull. And give your goals purpose. Answer both questions. What do I want? That's the object. And the second question, what for? That's purpose. Purpose is stronger than object. What you want is powerful and it will pull, but what you want it for is more powerful.
Let me ask a simpler question. What makes you happy? The thing that makes us happy are the things that we're passionate about. I really like, and when they say that, their face lights up. Then why don't you do more of that? Well, I can't because, you don't want to be great. You're not ready to be great. You want to be good. You want to be okay. But you don't want to be great. Because great takes work. Great takes a level of discipline that is distraction-free.
All it takes is somebody wanting to take a step. And there are certain things that a lot of people in this world are sitting there thinking in their minds, and they're just not going to do. Like, I used to always try to pull a lot of people and be like, you can do this, you can do this. But the people that hear that motivation over and over again, sometimes they take that step. Some people just have it in them. Early, it just starts, and they just get in the muscle memory of just doing things. And if you fail, so what? You know, you start over, you do it again. But